Hey, horse people.
cleaning up my computer because the stupid modem went down. I found this old, I had to reboot and reload and all this other crap. Anyway, I found this old morality test. So this isn't really about horses, but I don't even know how I can relate it to horses. But it's kind of a morals test, and this test was written a long time ago, and it kind of gives you a judge. This psychologist did this test, and he made it up. It started out as a joke at a dinner party, and then he made it up, and he asked some people, and then you answer, and it has certain responses depending on how you answer. So I'm going to read it to you, and it's about Robin Hood. And most people know the story of Robin Hood, but to give you a quick synopsis of Robin Hood. And his best buddy, Little John, used to steal from the rich and give to the poor. And he'd also steal from the government and taxes. And the Sheriff of Nottingham hated Little John and Robin Hood because they stole from the taxes and people were rebelling and it was a thing. And Maid Marion is Robin Hood's girl. I don't know if they were married or not, but it's his woman. They love each other. So that's kind of the short story of Robin Hood. And the reason why I tell you that is because this thing tells you ignore everything you know about it. But most people know the story of Robin Hood. That's why I picked the story. So I'm going to read this little story to you. So grab a pen and a paper. And you're going to write down these four characters. And then you're going to have to write down how you place them in according to the test. So you got your little pen. The four characters are Robin Hood, Robin, Little John, Maid Marian, and the Sheriff of Nottingham. Alright, so here's the story. How are your morals? What is your attitude to morals, sex, and honesty? Fascinating personality test written by Sydney, marriage expert, qualified psychologist. It began at a dinner party as a conversation, and then he prepared this form for the readers to test themselves. To do the test, you must give your honest opinion about morals and honesty of the four characters of our story of Sherwood Forest. Forget any preconceived ideas you may have about them. This is a different sort of story from all others. So here's the story, and it's pretty short. It's less than a paragraph, or it's about a paragraph. Here's the story. You got your pen, you got to write together. You don't have to write them right now. Just listen to the story and then rank them on according to what I just read as far as their morals and sex and honesty. Of course, my screensaver just kicked on. I'm trying to hide this from the sun because it's got the glare. All right, here's the test. The Sheriff of Nottingham captured Little John and Robin Hood and imprisoned them in his maximum security dungeon. Maid Marion begged the sheriff for their release, pleading her love for Robin. The sheriff agreed to release them only if Maid Marion slept the night with him. To this, she agreed. The next morning, the sheriff released his prisoners. Robin at once demanded that Marion tell him how she persuaded the sheriff to let him go free. Marion confessed the truth and was bewildered when Robin abused her, calling her a slut, and saying that he never wanted to see her again. At this, Little John defended her, invited her to leave Sherwood with him, and promising a lifelong devotion. She accepted, and they rode away together. Okay, so those are the facts. So now, in terms of realistic everyday standards of behavior, put Robin, Marion, Little John, and the sheriff in the order in which you consider they showed the most morality and honesty. There is no right answer, and the following is a psychologist's estimate of where you are. So there's 23 answers, or 23 ways that this can go. You know, you can put the sheriff first, you can put the sheriff last, you can put the Marion first, Marion last, Robin first, in the middle. So you list the four, and you can replay the story here. List the four on how you think what the test is. And then in the comments, go ahead and explain your answer. And I'm going to post in the description. Don't read the description. I know you guys, you're going to be little cheaters, and you're going to go read the description before you put what you got. So don't read the description. All my times, I always say, read the description for more information. On this video, don't read the description. Just make your list after you make your four, then go to the description, and I have all the answers and variables. And under each one, we'll tell you what your morals and values are, what you place on, depending on how you place who first, who last, who's in the middle, who's closest to the last, who's closest to the front. So do this little test. It's an interesting little test. Be quiet. Nobody wants to hear from you. So after you do the test, after I get a whole bunch of comments and kind of see how this goes, I'll post a comment and maybe I'll do a follow-up video on the morality test. So this is my horsey morality test. Maybe it'll shed some light on why barn witches are what they are and why barns and horse people are the way they are. All right, we'll end that there.